Hi guys, today we'll be making an orange cake. So here's my bowl with half a teaspoon of salt, 3 eggs, and that is half a cup of sugar. My son doesn't like a lot of sugar, so if you like a lot of sugar, you can put a whole cup, then you beat it. I was using a manual hand mixer, but if you have the electric one, well and good. So you beat it for around 2 to 3 minutes. And then you add 1 cup of cooking oil. See how good it looks after being beaten for about two minutes. And then we are adding flour. That is 1.5 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and 2 tablespoons of corn flour. And then you put a little by little as you fold it in. Remember not to overmix because we need our cake to be soft and airy. And then I forgot to tell you guys, after putting all the flour, it became a little bit hard, so I added some milk. As you can see here, the color has changed, so I added some milk. The consistency is now good. This one is okay for baking. It's not too light, not too thick. And then you add 1 teaspoon of orange essence, because I didn't have any oranges in my house and I had this essence in my cabinet. I decided, okay, I'm gonna try this orange cake and see how it's gonna turn out. So yeah, we'll see at the end. I added some raisins. So the trick is to coat them with flour so that they don't sink at the bottom. And then I decided to hand pick them as I put them in the batter because I didn't want to put the excess flour. So yeah, and then that is it. We put it in the already buttered baking pan. And then you put it in the oven at 200 degrees for 30 minutes, and that's the results. It looks good. A little bit cracked. Sorry. I was a little bit too excited, so I wasn't concentrating on the phone. So here it is, out of the oven. We're going to let it sit for 10 minutes, then scrape out the sides, then put it on the cooling rack. And yeah, we'll see how it turns out.
1, 2, 3.
So here, the cake is already cold. So as I'm cutting through, it feels like a store-bought cake. I'm actually surprised how amazing it looks, considering I did put corn flour. And let's see the inside. Wow. It looks amazing. It has a... It's soft, not oily. I think it's the best cake I've baked this far. I think the corn flour by far is good. Yeah, you can add a little bit, so it's taste time. We have to taste it, then we see. So the cake is a little bit you can feel the corn flour on the outer part of the cake. But it's actually very good. It tastes good. The texture is good. So let me try the inside and see how it feels like. So I think next time I will put 1 tablespoon of corn flour instead of 2. Although I had Googled online and I saw that you put 1 tablespoon in every 1 cup of flour. So yeah, so I think I did a very great job. You can try it yourself and see how it's going to turn out, although it's going to be perfect. Subscribe and thanks for watching.